Shang Tang defeated King Ji of the Zha Dynasty. The Shang Dynasty began. It took many years of bloodshed before Shang Tang started the Shang Dynasty. It actually took 17 years to overthrow Emperor Ji, but in the end, the emperor was overthrown and a new dynasty began. In the Shang Dynasty, the social and political structure was called feudalism. That's where the king was the most powerful. Then came the nobles, and then there were the peasants. In feudalism, the king gives part of his land to a noble, and the noble has to take care of the land he owns, or the king takes back the land. There were many jobs in the Shang Dynasty, but most people were farmers. There were many other jobs, too. You could be a miner, a blacksmith, a stonemason, a warrior, or a carpenter. The most minor jobs were lumberjacks, spinners, craftsmen, and the king.
The most important leaders were the kings. The first king, Shang Tang, maintained his rule for 30 years. He was a great leader. Shang Tang abolished the persecution and oppression that was carried out by King Ji of the Zha Dynasty. The last leader, on the other hand, had ruled for 33 years and was one of the worst leaders ever. The last king's name was Di Jin. He devised many cruel laws and means of torture. The architecture of a person's house during the Shang Dynasty was based on what class you were in. The art in the Shang Dynasty was usually made on and of bronze, and they also did pottery when the Europeans introduced the potter's wheel to China. Only rich boys were educated. Schools were in temples because they had nowhere else to put them. About 2% of the population was educated, and less than 1% went to college. The Shang were the first to use written characters and numbers. The Zha did not write. To be a scribe, you must memorize about 10,000 characters. The Shang also invented calligraphy, which is a fancy form of writing written with a special pen.
In the Shang Dynasty, the kings didn't expand the borders of China because of their placement in China. They owned large amounts of the land along the Yellow River. The people of the Shang Dynasty lived in a valley with steep sides and walled cities, so they were safe. The one setback was that the Yellow River flooded, inflicting heavy damage to the houses. The valley stopped some invaders, but it also cut back on the interaction with other countries. Another reason why the Shang people didn't interact with other countries was that transportation for trading with other countries, like boats and planes, had not been invented yet.
During the Shang Dynasty's rule, women and children were treated very badly. Women were not educated. They were arranged to marriage at 12 or 13. When they were married, they moved to their husband's house and obeyed their husband and stepmother.
The Shang Dynasty achieved many things. They were the first people to use the oracle bones, which are used to ask for guidance from the gods. The Shang people also developed the writing script, which was a script they used when they wrote. Another invention the Shang people made was when they invented the first accurate calendar in bronze. Bronze was made of copper and tin. The last religious achievement the Shang people made was when they were the first to use ancestor worship.
One important religious belief of the Shang Dynasty was the communication with ancestors using oracle bones. They were made from tortoiseshell and cracked. Then, an augur would read the cracks and see what that ancestor was saying. They also invented the Chinese zodiac using one animal for each year and worshipped dragons. Throughout the whole dynasty, a Shang person's main diet was made up of grains such as wheat, sorghum, millet, and rice. They drank water because tea was not invented yet. They loved peaches, but most people never tasted one. They also made noodles using millet and rice.
The Shang Dynasty fell when King Wu of the Zhou Dynasty killed Di Jin. The government was in disarray, which helped King Wu to kill the king. King Wu's attack was a surprise attack. None of the government officials knew what to do, so King Wu defeated the Shang Dynasty.